Now question is two disks of moments of inertia I1 and I2 about their respective axes, which is normal to the disk and passing through the center and rotating with angular speeds omega 1 and omega 2 are brought into contact face to face with their axes of rotation coincident. A. What is the angular speed of the two disk system? B. Show that the kinetic energy of the combined system is less than the sum of the initial kinetic energy of the two disks. How do you account for this loss in energy? Take omega 1 is not equal to omega 2. So see here that formula for initial kinetic energy, which is half common term I1 square omega I1 omega 1 square plus I2 omega 2 square. This is our initial kinetic energy formula, right? Simple for both the objects. Now initial momentum, right? That is I1 omega 1. Initial momentum I1 omega 1 plus I2 omega 2, right? Now final, that formula is 1 by 2 I1 plus I2. Now both are moving with same angular speed, so that's why omega square. Now final is I1 plus I2, final angular momentum I1 plus I2 into omega. Angular momentum always remains constant as per law of conservation of angular momentum. Li is equal to Lf, so I can write directly that omega is equal to I1 omega 1 plus I2 omega 2 upon I1 plus I2, right? Now see here Ef, put this omega in that formula, Ef is equal to I1 plus I2, right? It is 1 by 2 here. And into the bracket I1 omega 1 plus I2 omega 2 upon I1 plus I2 whole square. So 1 gets cancelled out, right? So we are left with EF is equal to 1 by 2 I1 omega 1 plus I2 omega 2 whole square upon I1 plus I2, okay. Now we are going to another page. So EF we found at last 1 by 2 I1 omega 1 plus I2 omega 2 whole square upon I1 plus I2, right? Now EF is equal to 1 by 2. Now I1 square omega 1 square plus I2 square omega 2 square plus 2 I1 omega 1 I2 omega 2 upon I1 plus I2, this bracket complete, right? So this is how we are getting our formula. See, we have only this in our EI, right? Half I1 square omega 1 square plus I2 square omega 2 square, right? Only that term we have in our EF, right? So see, omega 1 is not equal to omega 2, right? So is equal to half I1 square omega 1 square plus half I2 square omega 2 square plus here 2 I1 omega 1 I2 omega 2 upon I1 plus I2, right? So this is our EF, right? Now so after all the calculation we will get EF as this equation. So after calculation we will get EF as positive, so that means EI minus EF greater than 0, that means EI is greater than EF. So initial kinetic energy is more than final kinetic energy. So here the loss of kinetic energy is EI minus EF, right? And that is positive because EI minus EF we will get as a positive value,